mean deviation, that's mean deviation divided by x bar. Now for discrete frequency, mean deviation is equal to summation fi module xi minus x bar divided by n, and for continuous frequency distribution, mean deviation is equal to summation fi module xi minus x bar upon n, and the mean deviation is same for all the types of frequency. But here we will keep one thing, my xi is equal to mid value of each plus. The value of xi will consider mid value of each class. So that's a very simple formula for the mean, that is called average. We can say the average deviation also, and coefficient of average deviation. Now we'll see the some examples of the mean deviation and coefficient of mean deviation. For ungrouped data, the weight xi is 46, 58, 60, 43, 75, 66, 51 or 81. 51 and 81. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. Now, to find the mean deviation, first we have to find the mean x bar is equal to summation xi upon n. So the total of the observations is positive value. So first we will discuss the 46 Now, the sum of Fi Xi is equal to summation Fi Xi is equal to 384. Now, in mod Xi Xi Fi karna hai, first we have to find the X bar. So, X bar is equal to summation Xi upon N and the summation Fi Xi, sorry, Fi Xi upon N 384 divided by N. So N is equal to 10 plus 10 plus 20 32. The total of the frequency is 32. So 384 divided by 32, 31 then 64, 32 64. So mean X bar is equal to 12. Now find the deviation from mean, and absolute deviation from mean nikalenge, then that's a 10 minus 12 is a positive 2, 1, 0, 1 and 2. Now Fi multiply to Fi into in modulus mean deviations, absolute mean deviation, 2 2 are 4, 8 1 the 8, 12 0, 8 1 the 8, 2 2 are 4. Now the sum of, to find the mean deviation, is equal to summation Fi in modulus Xi minus X bar upon N. So sum Fi modulus Xi minus X bar is equal to 8 plus 4, 12 plus 12, 24. So 24 divided by N is equal to 32, 8 4 the answer is 0.75. So mean deviation is equal to 0.75. And coefficient of mean deviation, so that's very simple. Coefficient of mean deviation is equal to MD upon X bar. So mean deviation is equal to 0.75 divided by 12. So the answer is 0.0625 is equal to 0.06. That is the answer of coefficient of mean deviation of a discrete frequency distribution. And last one, for continuous frequency distributions. Now let's see one example for continuous frequency distribution, and the topic mean deviation will be completed, or coefficient, and then we'll see the next one, standard deviation or coefficient of standard deviation, in our next session or next lecture. Here the class, the marks obtained by students, the marks 0 to 9, 19, then 10, 20, 30 and 40. So 19, 29, 39 and 49 marks, and the number of children that's Fi 13862. Now we know very well, for all the class first we have to find the mean value and the Xi. So the 0 to 9, 0 plus 9, 9 divided by 4.5. Now the class length is 10, so we add 10, 14.5, 24.5, 34.5 and 44.5. That's the Xi. Now the next one, that's a very simple. Up means jo bhi hai wo simple, first we will find the Fi Xi. To find the mean Fi Xi, we can use a deviation method, it means DI, for the simplification, but okay, we'll see the same as the Fi DI method. 1 into 4 point, the Fi Xi answer is 4.5. Then 13 into 4, 14 3 jar, 42 and 1.5, 43.5, 8 into 24.5. So 25 means 200, but usme se 8 into 0.5 24 and 2 carry करते हैं तो 2 plus 1 3 4 5 the answer is 540 and ये total चाहिए हमें 8 plus 2 10 10 और 10 20 now x bar is equal to x bar find करेंगे then we find the xi minus x bar fi into module xi minus x bar. So first we find the x bar is equal to submission fi xi upon n. So submission fi xi 500 n is equal to 540 divided by 20. ये 0 मतलब तो आंसर हमारा 27. So mean x bar is equal to 27. Now we find the xi minus x bar. We find the but all the values are considered. 4.5 into 27. So 27 and 4.5 22.5. Now simple है. अब means बहुत ही simple. ये cut ये reduce होते जाएंगे यहाँ पे. फिर उसके बाद यहाँ से वापस increase होना है. तो यहाँ से 10 कम कर तो ये 10 कम हो रहा है तो 12.5 यहाँ से और 10 इंक्रीज हो रहे हैं 10 कम हो जाएंगे कैसे 2.5 यहाँ पे अगेन इस